I'm Scott Roberts of Roberts Insurance. I am proud to be part of an insurance agency that has been serving North Florida since 1963. We have a long, rich tradition of not only serving the insurance needs of our clients and community, but also being part of the community in which we serve. By participating in local nonprofit organizations, civic groups, and local schools, we have over 30 companies to serve your needs, whether it be auto, personal, or commercial, homeowners, mobile home, business, workers' comp, life, health, accident insurance. Come by and meet my friendly and experienced staff.
Sick and tired of small paychecks? Never getting home and spending more time in the shop than on the road?
We can help!
Davis Express, a Southeast regional refrigerated carrier boasting 30 years of success, knows the importance of taking good care of our drivers and their family. We offer excellent pay, great home time, and top-notch equipment. So apply online at www.davis-express.com or call us today at 800-874-4270 to see what Davis Express can do for you.
When Paulette and I decided that Bradford County was where we would stay and raise our children, we had no idea how blessed we would be 20 years later. This community embraced my family as my wife struggled with cancer and through my two overseas deployments with the Army Reserve. Thank you. In my career, I've argued cases all the way to the Florida Supreme Court. I've successfully led the defense of the Ten Commandments in front of our courthouse, helped deliver justice in the mountains of Afghanistan, and relief to the refugee camps of Haiti. If you want a lawyer that knows what it means to live, serve, and raise a family right here in Bradford County, call me. I'm Dan Sykes, and I am your hometown attorney.
Hey, I'm Lori Thompson, agent and agency manager of Roberts Insurance. We were established in 1963. That is over 52 years ago. I have been with this agency for 30 of those years. We are the oldest independent agency in Bradford County. Our agency prides itself on knowledge, experience, and caring for our customers. We are also your local Florida Blue agent. Come see us for all your affordable health care insurance needs.
So enjoy your popcorn tonight, but on Friday afternoons, stop by our agency and see us for free popcorn and a pen.
little bit more that has to be said. You play me now, I play you too. Let's just call it over. All the broken hearts in the world still be. Let's not make it harder than it has to be.
Thank you. the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
At this time, please welcome Bradford Senior Executive Chaplain Christy Yates to the stage, who will come forward and lead us in prayer.
Would you please join me in prayer? Father God, we come before you tonight with grateful hearts. We praise you for these past 4 years and the moments that have led us to tonight. I pray that you be with us now during this time of celebration and that you will be glorified in this ceremony. I thank you for each of the students sitting before me, Lord. The class of 2015 is a family, and just like any family, we've been through some good times and some bad times. But no matter the circumstance, we emerged as a stronger, tighter unit. So thank you, Lord, for being with us through those times and proving your faithfulness over and over again. I pray a special blessing over each of my classmates, Lord, that you'll lead them through life and provide them with the knowledge, wisdom, and abilities to accomplish the goals you've laid out for them. We also come before you tonight grateful for the many teachers, mentors, coaches, and counselors that have been faithful to us these last 4 years. We can't begin to describe the blessing they have been and the impact they continue to make on our lives. May they know how much we love them and appreciate them. We thank you, Lord, for the families and friends who have traveled tonight to share this special time with us and for a community that rallies behind its students. Wherever we end up in life, may we always know that we have a home in Bradford County. May you be glorified in every aspect of our lives and every event that takes place tonight. We love you, Lord, and pray all this in Jesus' precious holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Harry, tell us. Hey. Howard.
You may be seated. At this time, please welcome Alexis Shealy, our senior class president, to give the senior class greetings.
Let's see if he's good. How's your audio now, Victor, from the truck?
On behalf of the class of 2015, tonight we welcome and thank you for being part of this special event that we have waited and worked for 13 long years. We came into Bradford High School in 2011 as 115 or so individuals, and now we are getting ready to leave here together as a group forever connected by our time here. Thank you, BHS, and our distinguished guests, family, friends, and others who came out to support our graduating class tonight. This turnout is incredible, and I'm extremely honored to be up here. Class of 2015, you know we've been congratulated 1,000 times today, but we worked pretty hard to get here, so one more time won't hurt. Congrats, we did it. When I was told I would be giving a speech several months ago, I tried to reminisce, but as I quickly realized, trying to sum up our time at Bradford would be an impossible task because there are so many great memories that could be said. But also, I will be in the only class who have ever won homecoming all 4 years. But I remember our parents winning. Or what about our junior prom, whenever it was blinded by the light? And now, for our final moment, let's take a selfie. To thank you, Bradford High School, on behalf of the graduating class of 2015 for everything you have done for us the past 4 years. Because of you, we are prepared to succeed.
Thank you, Alexis. It is our honor to introduce to you our distinguished stage guest. Please hold your applause until all guests have been recognized. Honored guests, please stand when your name is called. Ms. Jennifer Farnsworth, Assistant Principal, Bradford High School. Mr. Anthony McCallum, Assistant Principal, Bradford High School. Mr. David Harris, Director, Bradford Union Career Technical Center. John Bayer, Valedictorian, Bradford High School 2015. Dana Carney, Salutatorian, Bradford High School 2015. Alexis Shealy, Senior Class President, 2015. Jordan Davis, Senior Class Vice President, 2015. Ms. Shelley Rogers, Senior Class Sponsor, Data Entry Clerk, and Mother of a 2015 graduate. Ms. Katrina Griffiths, Principal Secretary. Mrs. Lisa Pravat, Assistant Superintendent, Bradford County Schools. Mr. Chad Farnsworth, Superintendent, Bradford County Schools. Senator Cam Ward, Alabama State Senator. Mr. Josh Rankin, Youth Minister, First United Methodist Church of Stark. I'd also like to welcome Bradford County School Board members to our ceremony. Please stand, school board members, if you would, when I call your name. Mrs. Erica Reddish. Mrs. Stacy Creighton. Mrs. Sheila Cummings. Mr. Albert Hersey, Board Vice Chairman. And Mr. Randy Jones, Board Chairman. Now we'd also take a moment and recognize another group of very important guests today. These are the people who worked long, hard hours just so you could have all of the necessities and specialties of life. They held your hands and invested their own life so you could reach today's special milestone. These wonderful guests sitting in our audience who have made sacrifices at times just so you could have the things you wanted. They have loved you unconditionally and stood by you when you were right and corrected you when you were wrong. They are your biggest fans, are present here tonight because they love you and are so proud of you. You are their pride and their joy this evening. Would all the parents and guardians of our 2015 graduates please stand and be recognized. And now if you please welcome Mr. Chad Farnsworth, Superintendent of Schools, you please come forward and say a few words.
Good evening and welcome to David Hurst Stadium for the class of 2015 Bradford High School commencement ceremony. I'm convinced that a little interesting weather throughout the course of the day is only appropriate backdrop for graduating a group of tornadoes as fine as these. How blessed are we that year in and year out the Lord always provides this window of opportunity for us to have such a celebration on such a joyous occasion for these young people. I'm honored to be here this evening to take part in sending another amazing group of BHS graduates out into the world. We have an extraordinary evening planned to honor the hard work of these young adults. I would like to take just a moment to thank the class of 2015 for how they've represented their community and their school system through the years. It's something to be proud of. You guys have been amazing, and I greatly appreciate the inspiration you have provided for not just myself, but all the educators by which you have touched the hearts of. We should all recognize that this group of students is different. This group of students overcame the most challenging academic standards to date mandated by the state of Florida to reach this status of graduate. For this feat, you should all be extremely proud of yourselves and hold your heads high. Lastly, I just wanted to say congratulations for a job well done. When you reflect back on this time in your life, I hope it generates a tingle in your heart and a smile on your face. And when the Spirit moves you, I hope you feel free to share the positive experiences with those you are surrounded by. Remember that this community is your home, and in this home, you are always loved. Thank you again, and I'll be praying for you as you embark on this journey into the next phase of your lives. Thank you so much, class of 2015. You guys are great, and we love you.
At this time, if we could please welcome Thomas Parker, our senior class senator, to the stage to give acknowledgement to our faculty and staff.
What's up, class of 2015 and parents? On behalf of student government and the class of 2015, I'd like to thank the teachers for not only teaching us and preparing us for our future, but for also being our friends and mentors. On behalf of the class, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Parker. Now Now, if you could please welcome Autumn Rogers, Senior Executive President, and Lingy Rogers, Senior Executive Vice President, to the stage for a very special presentation.
In our short time as BHS students, we have had certain people who touch our lives but were taken away from us too soon. Tonight, we wish to honor the lives of three special people who we grew to know and respect. Mr. Stevens was a part of the school system for 30 years, from coaching to teaching to administration. Mr. Stevens was a part of our freshman and sophomore years as our principal. He was a man of few words, always followed the rules, and stood behind the students. Ms. Groves came into our lives at Bradford Middle School. She was the voice over the intercom and the smiling face when you came in the front office and the person who could give the greatest hugs when we needed them. She worked at BMS for many years.
And last but most definitely not least, one of our own classmates that should be sitting with us tonight and celebrating his accomplishments with us. Deshaun Jaleel Ford was a quiet young man with a big heart and always had a smile on his face. The Lord took him home on April 22nd, 2013. However, he will always be a part of the class of 2015. Our class would like to remember these three wonderful people who came into our lives with a peace lily for each of their families. We would also like to honor our classmate, Deshaun, by presenting his family with a shadow box containing a cap, gown, and medallion. As we read this poem, we ask that Deshaun's family come to the front of the stage to receive this token of our love.
Many things have happened since they were called away, so many things to share with them that they've been left to stay. And now on this graduation day, memories do come our way. Though absent, they are ever near, still missed, remembered, and always dear. Please join us now for a moment of silence as we honor and remember these. They will always be a part of our lives. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies, and a special thank you to the Ford family for being with us this evening. At this time, Ms. Jennifer Farnsworth will come forward.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight is the fourth year that we have had educators join us this evening that have been a part of your students' educational journey from K through 12th grade. In January, the students got together and wrote letters to teachers or educators that had impacted their life in a positive way. If those educators that were invited this evening by students could please stand so that we can acknowledge you. Academic excellence and the hard work they have put into graduating at the top of their class. The class of 2015 salutatorian is graduating with a 4.74 GPA. She has been dual enrolled at Santa Fe College and was the first student or even an adult that earned all three industry certifications in CompTIA A+, NET+, and Security+. At the Bradford Union Technical Center. After graduation, she plans to attend the University of Georgia to continue her studies and earn a degree in dietetics. Please give a warm welcome to the class of 2015 salutatorian, Dana Carmen.
I'd just like to say two things before I begin my actual speech. One, I am super nervous, and I'm not going to lie about it. Two, Thomas Hales is probably the greatest person ever, and he owes me $10 for saying that. I will see you afterwards. So with that aside, administration, faculty members, fellow students, family, and friends, welcome. We never thought this day would come. We prayed for its quick delivery, crossed days off our calendars, counted hours, minutes, and seconds, and now that it's here, I'm sorry it is, because it means leaving friends who inspire me, teachers who have been my mentors, so many people who have shaped my life and my fellow students' lives impermeably and forever. For the past 17 years, I've been overwhelmingly blessed by those around me. I'd like to first thank my mom, especially for all those things we never really thank moms for. Thank you for being an inspiration. Thank you for always supporting me, and especially thank you for never being one of those moms who snuck vegetables into dessert. Thank you, and I love you, because I don't think any of us say it enough. I'd like to thank my closest friends, Bailey, Kelsey, Christy, Rachel, and Rhonda, and that was in alphabetical order, so no one get mad about where you were. Although we may have called our friend group many different names over the years, including my personal favorite, coined by Rachel's dad, The Herd, the past 4 years with you all have been nothing short of phenomenal. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do without you. I'd like to thank all of our teachers who somehow managed to teach us information while dealing with our hyperness in elementary school, our weirdness in middle school, and our I really do not care about this-ness in high school. I'd like to thank the class of 2015. Thank you for homecoming skits and floats. Thank you for middle school dances and prom. I cannot imagine these past few years with a better class. And last but certainly not least, I'd like to thank God for bringing us here today and for being with us tomorrow. When we step off this field tonight, we are entering a new world of new people, new challenges, and new obstacles. And if there's one piece of advice I could give to you, it's that whatever you do, don't let fear hold you back. There's a quote by Eleanor Roosevelt that reads, "Do one thing every day that scares you." For a lot of us girls tonight that's wearing heels or wedges, I respect that, we the real MVPs. So I want all of you to take this quote and try to apply it to your life post high school, but don't go crazy. So a personal example of mine is, I am terrified of roller coasters, and a little while back, me and my best friend Christy were at Hollywood Studios in Disney World. And if you've ever been to Hollywood Studios, you know that there's the ride Rockin' Roller Coaster. It's the fastest ride in the parks. It goes upside down. It's just crazy, okay? So long story short, we're waiting in line, and I'm like kind of freaking out, but I'm trying to be cool about it, you know? And somehow, when it's our turn to ride this ride, Christy gets us the front two seats. I've never been in an upside down roller coaster before, and I'm just, no. She's over here like, yeah, first two seats. And I'm like, this is punishment I don't deserve. So for about the first 10 seconds, I couldn't figure out how to breathe. And for the entire ride, I couldn't open my eyes without seeing my life flash before them. And that's exactly what I don't want you to do. Don't think that you should go out every day and have what feels like a near-death experience. However, I am suggesting that maybe talking to someone new that you normally wouldn't talk to, going after that job position you have no chance at, or being more embracing of ideas that you would normally challenge, that's a good thing to try. So another personal example, in my second class at Santa Fe, I had ENC 1101 with Mrs. Compass. I don't know if she's here, but go Mrs. Compass if she is. One of the first essays we were assigned was an argumentative essay over the topic of free speech. I honestly could not even tell you what I wrote about at this point, but I can tell you what my title was, except not in public, because it contained an expletive, because 15-year-old me thought, hey, what a better way to support free speech than to put a cuss word in my title of my essay. And needless to say, I definitely got a stern look and a do not ever do that again from Ms. Compass, but I also got an A on the paper. And that's what I'm talking about. Take chances, make mistakes, get messy, and do that one thing every day that scares you. In the end, you may not gain anything, but you certainly won't lose anything either. Again, class of 2015, thank you for the past 4 years and all the experiences I will never forget. I wish you all luck in every journey you choose to take in life. Peace out.
Thank you, Dana. We are all very, very proud of you. At this time, please welcome Rhonda McCormick, Senior Class Treasurer, Katie Morris, Senior Class Senator, Taylor Crawford, Senior Class Senator, and Jordan Davis, Senior Class Vice President, to please come up and present the class motto, song, flower, and verse of 2015.
The class of 2015 song is I Will Always Remember You by Miley Cyrus.
Our class flower is the Forget Me Not. Its meaning is Remember Me Always.
Our class motto is We Didn't Know We Were Making Memories. We Just Thought We Were Having Fun.
Class verse, Proverbs 3, verses 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight.
Thank you, ladies. And I'm going to welcome Miss Farnsworth back to the stage to introduce our valedictorian.
This year's valedictorian is graduating with a 4.77 GPA. He has been dual enrolled at Santa Fe College and has excelled in his academic studies. He was selected as a National Merit Scholar, which is a prestigious award and scholarship a very small percentage of students in our country are able to achieve. After graduation, he plans to attend the University of Alabama, where he has pretty much had everything paid for. He will continue his studies and earn a degree in chemistry. Please welcome, at this time, John Bayer, the class of 2015 valedictorian.
Good evening. On behalf of the class of 2015, I'd like to welcome all of you and thank you for coming, in spite of the inclement weather. Now, normally I would take full advantage of this opportunity to unload my rambling thoughts on all of you, as you are a captive audience, but I was planning on it being extremely hot. However, I suppose the threat of imminent rain is a valid excuse for my keeping this short. I was hoping you would laugh there. Thank you for the pity. Now, Robert Frost's poem, The Road Not Taken, begins with the words, "Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. And sorry I could not travel both and be one traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth." The Road Not Taken is no doubt Frost's most famous work, at least amongst high school students. Even if it's not covered in English class, it is often quoted on television and by people who want to sound intelligent while giving a speech. Regardless of where you hear it, this poem raises an important fact. Life is full of choices. Some choices we make once, like where to go to college or which job to pick. But there are other choices we make in life that we make every day. Small choices, but important ones nonetheless. To that end, I would like to share with you the three most influential pieces of advice I have heard in my reasonably short life. First, from Shakespeare's Hamlet, "To thine own self be true, and it must follow, as the night the day, thou canst not be false to any man." Second, from the Hippocratic Oath, "Do no harm." And lastly, this one from my father, "Whether you're a businessman or a garbage man, work as hard as you can in everything you do." If you choose to work your hardest, choose to be honest with people, and choose not to hurt people, you will be the best version of yourself you can. And that is all anyone can legitimately ask of you. Have a good evening.
Thank you, John. We will miss you and wish you the best in all that you do. At this time, if we could please give a warm welcome for Mr. McCallum to the stage to introduce our guest speakers.
Let's test out the mic real quick. Class of 2015, can you hear me? Yeah. There we go. Good evening. I would like to introduce Josh Rankin, youth pastor at First United Methodist Church of Stark.
I just get the honor of blessing you guys and just praying over you. So community tonight, can we just pray together? Jesus, messy. I think for parents, I think for families, and this night and in this moment, it's been a messy few years getting them to this point. And man, what an amazing accomplishment. And but we're here now. Ladies and gentlemen, you guys have made it. And God, you've been watching over us. You've been guiding us. And you lay a path before our feet, as it says in Scripture, and we decide whether we want to take that path or not. And it gets rocky sometimes, and it gets confusing, and sometimes it's clear, and sometimes it's not. But God, you say that your word is a lamp to our feet. And a lot of times it's frustrating because we just want to know what to do. We want to know what's next. We want it to be a 1,000-kilowatt spotlight that shows us our future and just lays out every single step. But God, you say in your word that it is a lamp to our feet. And it's interesting, when you think about a lamp in the forest, it only shows you a few steps. It only just shows you a little bit. But by faith, when we take it step by step, you show us a little bit more. Because God, if it was a spotlight, we wouldn't need you along the journey. We wouldn't need you along the way. And so God, we say thank you. Thank you for getting us to this point, to graduation, to this night, and to the class of 2015. May you know that it is not over, that God has gotten you to this point, but you still need him along the path. And so family and friends, we are surrounding this class right now with love and support. We believe in them so much, and the potential sitting in these seats right now is incredible. God, may your spirit be upon them. May your light guide them. And may your love shine down upon them as they continue the journey and step fearlessly into the future and all that you are going to give them. May your hand bless them. We love them, the class of 2015. And may we continue to point them to you with everything that we have. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
At this time, I have the pleasure of introducing our 2015 commencement speaker. Senator Cam Ward was born in Milton, Florida, and grew up right here in Bradford County. He attended Southside Elementary, Bradford Middle School, and graduated in 1989 from Bradford High School. Not only was he student council president, he was captain of the track team and cross country team. In 1989, Senator Ward received a leadership scholarship to Troy University. He quickly got involved in student activities, serving two terms as president of the Troy University Student Government Association. In 1993, he was admitted to Cumberland School of Law. Upon graduation from Cumberland, Senator Ward was admitted to the Alabama State Bar. Over the past 20 years, Senator Ward has held the following positions: Assistant Alabama Secretary of State, District Director of Congressman Spencer Bacchus, Executive Director, Alabaster Industrial Development Board, Alabama House of Representatives. Senator Ward is serving as Alabama State Senator. He was recently appointed to the National Criminal Justice Board. Senator Ward lives in Alabaster, Alabama. That's also kind of fun to say there, Senator. Alabama, and in Alabama, he lives with his wife, Julie, and his daughter, Riley. At this time, please welcome Senator Cam Ward.
Hands down, this is probably one of the hardest speeches I've ever had to give. And I say that to say I've been in the legislature for 15 years, but I sat there where you guys are sitting right now, and you know what? I remember sitting on this field thinking, when in the world is that guy going to shut up? So I promise you this, it'll be short and brief. First of all, let me say thank you and congratulations to all the men and women out here sitting in front of me, graduates, and congratulations to the families who did so much to help these graduates get here today. You should be honored and proud. Y'all should all be proud of these graduates. Let's give our graduates a round of applause, please. I'll be very brief. As a former graduate here who ran track right over there and who worked out in the gym right over there, I can tell you that since that time, I have lost a lot of hair, gained a little weight, gotten thin and gray, but I'm always a Bradford County High School Tornado, and I'm proud to be one. You guys are great. It's fantastic to be here tonight. You know, sometimes we sit around, and if I can give you three messages today, I want to give you three things of my thoughts that I want to share with you. First and foremost is this. You know, we live in an age where we're always connected. That goes to the parents, that goes to students, all of us. Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook. We're so connected everywhere around the world, but guess what? 65% in the latest Gallup poll said this. We do not feel like we have any connection with anybody in the world. Yet we have more technology today. We have more devices. We have more opportunities to talk to people. I can call someone in China tonight and talk to them. And guess what? I still feel like I'm somehow disconnected. I have no connection with anybody else in the world. You know why? The reason is this. My first piece of advice would be every once in a while, we all need to put down our cell phones, put down whatever it is we're carrying with us. And you know what? Talk to people. Talk to one another. As graduates, you're going to meet new friends. You're going to maintain old friends. Make sure you do your best, not just to keep up with them on Facebook, not just to keep up on Twitter, not just to keep up on Instagram or Snapchat. Make sure that you spend your time talking to them and helping them, because there are going to be tough times ahead. And that's our goal, my goal, your goal. We should always do that. Second, one of the biggest issues I've always noticed is, and this is so funny, how we take the time to spend so much energy in ourselves that we forget sometimes that we forget to ask other people questions. You know, there's somehow, some way, become a dichotomy in this world where diversity was a bad thing. Embrace it. Embrace your friends, embrace your classmates, embrace your new friends that you're going to meet when you graduate from here. Embrace the diversity they have. Embrace the differences you have, because the problems you see today, and I come to you from a situation of politics. I come to you from as a state senator in Alabama, but I could tell you the same thing from Washington. I could tell you the same thing from Tallahassee. I could tell you the same thing from the city council here in Stark. The issue is this. We fail to embrace the fact that sometimes people disagree with me. Sometimes people don't think the same way I do. Why don't we spend some more time saying, you know what? I understand you disagree with me. I understand that you and I may not agree with each other, but we should spend more time respecting each other's views. We should do that more often. We don't do that enough. Also, you know what else we should do? Don't spend so much time being scared and worrying about the small things. You know why? Because we spend so much time worrying about our day-to-day lives. I know that, or I may be wrong here, but I believe the parents out here would agree with me on this. We hope all of you get good jobs. I think the parents would agree with me on that one. I know I sure do for my daughter. And also, not only should we hope that you succeed, but you should also take the time to succeed, but also enjoy your lives, because you never know what's going to happen. I've had friends in my life who've had cancer. I've had friends who died from cancer. I've had friends who suddenly had a stroke, fell over, gone forever. I only say that to say this. We should always spend as much time as we can, as much opportunity as we can. You as friends, as graduates, your friends, your dear friends, some of them like family to you. Make sure we spend the time, the energy that we can to enjoy the small moments. I say that to say this. Make sure to spend time dancing. Make sure spending time to do the things that are fun and happy, whether it be you love music, whether it be you love reading, whether it be you love drawing pictures, art, culture, whether you love telling jokes, whether you love talking to people, having fun. Remember those small moments. And the reason why is this, because you never know when tomorrow is going to throw a curveball at you. We have to spend more time, all of us, me included, enjoying ourselves, having fun, laughing, enjoying those moments that we never thought we were going to get. Do that more often, because you will never realize when the person sitting next to you may not be there tomorrow. It's not to be grim. That's to be thankful. That's to be happy. That's to be saying we should be thankful that we have so many graduates in front of us that are friends and family, whether you're wearing the gray or the red, you're a tornado, you're a brother or a sister. We should always make sure we take that time to enjoy each other. Too many times, we spend so much effort worrying about big things, big efforts, big issues, things that necessarily that sound important today, but when you realize tomorrow, they're really not. So take that time, please do. And I can tell you this, I will leave you on this final note. Remember this. Never, ever, ever take yourself too seriously. Trust me, never take yourself too seriously. But always take what you're doing in your day-to-day task, whether it be your career, whatever that may be, whether it be your friendship, whether it be your marriage, whether it be your job, whether it be whatever you're doing in life, take that seriously. Don't take yourself too seriously, but take what you're doing in life seriously, and you'll be okay. Never settle for second best. Never settle for a lack of good. Only settle for the best. But remember this, take the time to enjoy yourself. And remember, you today are graduating. You graduates are going to do a great job. You're going to succeed in life, but succeed in a way that makes you happy. Because success is not always measured in monetary value. It's not always money. It's not always what your status is in jobs. It's always about one thing. How are you going to be happy? What's going to make you happy? Your family happy? Because we all grow old one day. We all get older. We all do something else in life. But I promise you, if you make sure that your success is based upon the happiness that you, your family, and whatever you do is successful, you're going to be okay. I am so honored to be back here with you tonight. And I can tell you that the speech I just gave you was about an hour shorter than the one I got when I graduated. So I appreciate that, and thank you very much. Congratulations, graduates. I'm proud of you, and I'm honored to be with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Ward, and for coming back to your alma mater to share your words of wisdom with us. At this time, please welcome Ms. Lisa Pravat to recognize our students earning AA degrees.
Good evening. I'd like to take a moment to start off thanking the superintendent and the board for maintaining a partnership with Santa Fe College, which is the number one college in the nation this year, and we're proud of that relationship, and we're thankful for the opportunity that it provides our students at Bradford High School. And I'd like to just take a moment to recognize one student who perseverance is the word that describes him. In his steadfastness to complete a difficult option that he chose in his life. He had to put in a lot of time, effort, and energy to accomplish this goal. He did not just graduate tonight with 24 credits that are required for graduation, but 32 and a half credits. And this student will also be graduating with his AA degree from Santa Fe College. So please stand so we can recognize Thomas Hales. Thomas, stand. Congratulations, Thomas.
Okay, so this is the moment we have been waiting for. Are we ready to do this? Okay. Please welcome Ms. Rogers, senior class sponsor, and Ms. Griffiths, Bradford High Principal Secretary, to present our seniors. And if Mr. Farnsworth could join me up front too to present our diplomas.
Rogers. Lainey K. Rogers. Kirsten Gail Woods. Erica Taylor Barnes. Deontay LaTroy.
I love you!
Desmond
Hallelujah. Hey! Chelsea Thomas, senior class senator, please come close us in prayer. Please hold on, family and friends. We still got a little bit more to do before we come on the field.
Thanking you for the many blessings you've bestowed upon our lives. Thank you for family and friends that have and will continue to stand alongside us in this journey called life. I pray no matter the circumstance, we turn to you and that we keep faith in your plan and purpose for our lives. Thank you for providing the knowledge and ability to obtain a bright, optimistic future. We understand nothing can be done alone while the unthinkable is possible with you by our side. Thank you for the class of 2015 and the amazing memories over the past 4 years together. We leave here and go our separate ways, but I pray the relationships formed will always hold a special place in our hearts. As we close this ceremony and chapter in our lives, I pray for safe travels as we leave here tonight and proceed to enter the rest of our lives. Class of 2015 gives all glory to God. Congrats, y'all. We made it. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
Thank you, Chelsea. I am proud to present to you this evening the Bradford High School Class of 2015. Each student here assembled has completed all requirements as prescribed by the Bradford County School Board and the state of Florida and is hereby entitled to receive a high school diploma or a certificate of completion. And now by the authority invested in me by the state of Florida and the Bradford County School Board, I pronounce upon those of you who have completed the necessary requirements, graduates of the Bradford County School System, and confer upon each of you all rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations. Seniors, one more time together as the Bradford High School class, would you please turn your tassels? Congratulations to each and every one of you.
I'm Scott Roberts of Roberts Insurance. I am proud to be part of an insurance agency that has been serving North Florida since 1963. We have a long, rich tradition of not only serving the insurance needs of our clients and community, but also being part of the community in which we serve. By participating in local nonprofit organizations, civic groups, and local schools, we have over 30 companies to serve your needs, whether it be auto, personal, or commercial, homeowners, mobile home, business, workers' comp, life, health, accident insurance. Come by and meet my friendly and experienced staff.
Sick and tired of small paychecks? Never getting home and spending more time in the shop than on the road?
We can help!
Davis Express, a Southeast regional refrigerated carrier boasting 30 years of success, knows the importance of taking good care of our drivers and their family. We offer excellent pay, great home time, and top-notch equipment. So apply online at www.davis-express.com or call us today at 800-874-4270 to see what Davis Express can do for you.
When Paulette and I decided that Bradford County was where we would stay and raise our children, we had no idea how blessed we would be 20 years later. This community embraced my family as my wife struggled with cancer and through my two overseas deployments with the Army Reserve. Thank you. In my career, I've argued cases all the way to the Florida Supreme Court. I've successfully led the defense of the Ten Commandments in front of our courthouse, helped deliver justice in the mountains of Afghanistan, and relief to the refugee camps of Haiti. If you want a lawyer that knows what it means to live, serve, and raise a family right here in Bradford County, call me. I'm Dan Sykes, and I am your hometown attorney.
Hey, I'm Lori Thompson, agent and agency manager of Roberts Insurance. We were established in 1963. That is over 52 years ago. I have been with this agency for 30 of those years. We are the oldest independent agency in Bradford County. Our agency prides itself on knowledge, experience, and caring for our customers. We are also your local Florida Blue agent. Come see us for all your affordable health care insurance needs.
So enjoy your popcorn tonight, but on Friday afternoons, stop by our agency and see us for free popcorn and a pen.